Hello, DoomRL fans, and welcome, or DRL, or I'm not sure what we're going to call it. I think just go with Doom the Roguelike still. I mean, it was only the website that ZeniMax technically see indeed. Anyhow, going to be playing a bit more of this because I'm having fun, and also because I got a bunch of tips in the last video. Tormuse was very nice and gave me loads of tips to survive and then, as a result, win. Because that's what surviving ultimately gets you, is a victory. But gonna go otherwise the same general idea as I had before, but one big thing that's different is that I'm going to have WASD movement. Like, so instead of having 8-way movement with 8 buttons, I have 8-way movement with 4 buttons. I was experimenting with this because there was some stuff. I mean, okay, Jupiter Hell, for those of you not familiar, well, I mean, I guess you weren't here for the last stream, since the last stream was all about saying, hey, you guys should kickstart Jupiter Hell, which was successfully kickstarted, which is nice. Anyway, one of the things that game is going to be doing in its quest for accessibility, and it's kind of understandable why, but it is going to be removing 8-way movement, or rather, going to have 4-way movement. And while I don't think I'm going to be able to convince anybody that there is a way of doing 8-way movement accessibly that does not involve numpads, because apparently that's the big reason, is that if you don't have a numpad on your computer, it's really difficult to do 8-way movement, and I can understand that. It actually is, if you think about it. Without a way of easily having all 8 buttons, it's kind of hard to make 8-way movement for people who aren't familiar with roguelike movement to begin with, and then it's like, oh, how does this work? And I thought, well, maybe there is a way. So I started trying to figure out, well, okay, what happens if I just shift the numpad over to WASD? Because a lot of people would be thinking in terms of shooters, WASD is kind of typical. Also, DoomRL and kind of by extension Jupiter Hell are somewhat shooter-based. Yay, medpack. They're somewhat shooter-based as far as roguelikes go. So I thought, well, maybe, just maybe, that would be a way of doing it, is you'd have, like, WASD and then QEZC as well for diagonals. That was clumsy. Didn't really work that well. It was a thing. That was a major mistake. Why did I do that? I have pistols. Actually, for that matter, I should... Oh. There you go. That was one of the tips, is use swappable weapons. Because it's faster. Ah! Crap. I'm dead. I think I'm dead. Yeah, okay, that was poor. Let's try that again. Oops, no. Why did I use the shotgun? I was not paying attention. If I'd used my pistol, I would have been fine. Whatever. The point is, that was a tactical error on my part, but hey. The point is that the controls for WASD QEZC, yeah, kind of a pain. Didn't really work that well. So I thought, well, what about other options? I started to look them up, and apparently, well, Infra Arcana, which I should have remembered, but I haven't played that in a while, uses a system where you have shift and control. So use the arrow keys normally. Oops, don't want to do that. Use the arrow keys normally, and then if you use shift plus an arrow key, you move north and the direction. So shift left, shift right is northeast, northwest, or sorry, northwest, northeast, respectively, and control is southwest, southeast. And that's a neat idea. Now, I tried that too, and it works all right, but I find it tends to bias if you're trying to, like, if I'm trying to do this, where I'm constantly switching diagonal directions, a little hard to show here, with, like, you should be able to just do that no matter how you're doing it without issues. Like, it should be, if you wanted to basically dance while going generally north, like go northeast, northwest, northeast, northwest, it should be as easy as dancing while going generally east or west. Also, I want you to pistol. And the problem is with the Infra Arcana setup, that's not the case. Did I get both med packs? I did! Awesome! Alright. So, I want to reload you, and I want to get you. So, the thing is, the Infra Arcana setup is interesting, because it does provide you with basically fully reliable keys with only 6 buttons rather than... Well, not just 6 buttons, but it's 4 buttons with modifier, so those other buttons can be used for other things. Shift plus anything other than the arrow keys, well, actually left and right arrow specifically, can be used for anything else. Or if you're doing WASD, it's just Shift A, Shift D. And that's a cool idea. The only problem I had with that in practice was that... Oops. It was a little bit... Ooh, nice, another med pack. It was a little bit unwieldy, like I said, moving... Like, doing this Oops. Or this was the easy way of doing things, but going generally east or west was a lot harder. That led me to think, well, what happens if you just have WASD, like shooter controls, straight up shooter controls? Now, the problem, of course, is that in general, you can't just have modifier keys that are like conditionally modifier keys. That doesn't make sense to have like conditional modifier keys. So I figured, well, okay, let's not go with that then. But it doesn't really matter, because at that point, you pretty much have to use auto hotkey anyway, and so I did. So honestly, it was several hours of scripting, of messing around with auto hotkey, which was surprisingly difficult for what I was trying to do. And I ended up managing to make it work, like make something that not only lets me do some sort of combination for diagonals, but also does it in a way that works seamlessly. Early attempts, I was trying to use, like, auto hotkey will actually just handle hotkeys naturally. It's in the name. So you can set it up so that if, say, I press the E key, it does one thing, or the W, A, or AS, or D keys, it might remap to something. And I can also set it up so I can do W plus A, or W plus D, or that sort of thing. And that's no problem. But the thing is that doing that with all those different keys is that it is... Okay, I can take those without wearing my barrels. Yes. All right, another gun. Yeah. So I can do that. Give me that. There we go. Anyway, I can do that setup without having to worry about using anything too complex. The problem, however, was that the way that auto hotkey works, if you set a hotkey to use some other key as a modifier, like I do W and A or W and D, well, if I want to hit W or D or A or S would also be used, none of those keys on their own would work. There was a way of handling that by making them have explicit hotkeys of their own, but the problem with that is it ends up being... Okay, you're gonna die. Ah, hit me. You're a pain. Anyway, the problem with that is that it ends up being... Go away. All right, you're done. So the problem is auto hotkey will only do the main key when you release it. So you can hold any diagonal, no problem, but the cardinal directions, you can't hold them. You have to release them in order for anything to work, which presents obvious issues because, well, if I want to hold down, if I want to just move in a direction, I should just be able to hold down the key. And then as soon as I let go, it should just stop. And that should hold for any direction. Gah. Okay, that was a testing I might have to fix, actually. Alright, so apparently there's a bug in the script I overlooked. But anyway, would you stop? I gotta figure out what's going on here. That's really bizarre. That wasn't happening before. Alright, well, good thing I tested this, because I just noticed... So yeah, apparently if I hold down diagonals, that doesn't work properly anymore. Whatever. Honestly, why are you holding down diagonals? If you're holding down any direction, what are you doing? There's run options for that. You can use that instead. Oh, I guess these are staircases, that's why. Why is it stopping my run? What the heck? Anyway, so the point is, when you're moving, might as well. I've got... Yeah, sure. Why not? All right. So, how many shells do I have? I only have 3 shells! Crap, did I forget to pick up shells? Okay, that was a mistake. This will be doable, but tricky. I do have the extra gun, so if I level up, I'll dual gunner. I got some tips to dual gunner basically as my second rather than, or third rather than fourth trait. But yeah, anyway, so the weakness with the default setup was that I could only hold down diagonals, not cardinals. So then I set up a thing where it's essentially buffered. What? Oh, shoot. So the idea is, when you hold down any cardinal direction, it considers that to be possibly there unless you press another button. And then it just goes, oh, well, you're moving diagonally. It's like a 50 millisecond delay, but it's there. However, if I release the key, it'll go, oh, well, you're obviously intending to move in that direction. So it just goes automatically without waiting. It's really hard to tell, though, because you can't see my key presses, but yeah, it's very minor delay. But it's enough that I can reliably move diagonally when I press. I don't have to worry about... As long as, apparently, I don't hold the key down, which is really bizarre, but yeah. Gah. Sheesh, I think I get shotgun shells after saying yes after the first round's done, so we'll see. Ow! Okay. Done playing Ring Around the Rosie? Okay. Yes. I have the resources to do so. Oh, I have three med packs. Okay, not great. Alright, let's dodge out here. Ow! Should be able to kill the cacodemon. There we go. Took far longer than it reasonably should have. There we go, dual gunner! Finally I can get some damage in this! And, oops, no. I want you to be pistol. And then heal up. One med pack left. Okay, that's a little tricky. But anyway. So yeah, the setup with the input buffer works quite well. But I got to figure out why. I mean, I guess I got to figure out what's going on. As a proof of concept, it works. The whole button holding thing is a little annoying that it causes weird issues. I think I know why, but whatever. The point is that overall the idea is sound, and it actually works quite well. Especially just pressing keys, and it doesn't do it with any real delay or anything. So, yeah. I'm happy with this. It actually feels really cool to play with a WASD setup. I mean, it makes sense for a roguelike based on a shooter, they'd play with standard shooter controls. Even though, actually, I typically play my shooters with, like, ESDF or RDFJ, but... or RDFG, rather, but that's just WASD shifted to the side bit. But yeah, with mRL, WASD, pure WASD works remarkably well! Provided I don't try to hold down a single button and expect that to do me any good. But, you know, other than that... Aha! Yes, I do choose to have the final challenge. Ah, yes, perfect. Okay, so I have shotgun shells, finally. Question is, where are the Hell Knights? There's one. And it takes 5 bullets, roughly, to kill them, I found. So that works. And I still have another med pack. Yes, I do! Awesome! Alright, so where's that Hell Knight? Probably on the other side, normally is... Actually, you know what? I have a bunch of shotgun shells. Oh, I have some shotgun shells. Over to my left, are you? 8 shotgun shells. I don't have Hell Run yet, so I figure... Ah, there you are. I figure it's probably best not to... Not you. I want to change you out. One thing I actually found while doing this is that Doomerl has a lot of little keys and... Oh, whoops. What? Doomerl has a... Ah, there we go. Awesome. Beat Hell's Arena. But yeah, Doomerl has a lot of things that you can do in menus. Like, in the equipment menu, you can hit tab. And that'll allow you to simply swap weapons rather than having to click on it to unequip and then click again in order to equip. Or, obviously, go to the inventory and just click on it. But it's pretty cool, because I think the equipment screen, really, once you learn that, becomes far more important than the inventory screen. The inventory screen is cool, and actually the inventory screen also doubles as a drop screen, thanks to this backspace. I totally missed that. I'm surprised I actually missed that for so long, but yeah, that's a thing. So, let's see here, I have more stuff. Ah, there's the supercharged globe. Should I have a rocket? There's the rocket launcher. All right. Gotta remember I have this too, because it came up in my last stream that I actually had a rocket launcher, and I didn't make anybody pay. And that's a complete waste, really. So I will make sure that if it comes up, I will use the rocket launcher. Okay, this is... That was... Whoa! That was a really fortuitous miss. I don't know how I kept missing that, but yeah. It, just two imps next to each other. Miss one, hit the other. That's always pretty cool. That's really hard to do intentionally, but... That's... You know, I know Jupiter Hell's going to be doing something with traits that's going to be similar, and dual-wielding pistols is going to be a thing, but I am curious how that's going to be handled. I mean, if there's going to be any traits that aren't just get a hit, reload. Because that's what it is in mRL. Ah! Why don't it be like an alternate fire mode where you can choose multiple targets to hit, and you can basically split your fire between them? Like, in here, I can aim a shot and that'll fire one gun, but it's more likely to hit. And that's cool. I should probably just pick this up. But... Ah. Which, incidentally, I am going to get Eagle Eye next. I was recommended to do that. I've been experimenting with it a bit. I'm going to continue experimenting with it because it seems effective, especially in situations like that where, yeah, it'd be nice to have dealt more damage. Like this, I had a higher level son of a gun. But I also just straight up missed. And it's a lot easier to deal damage when you're hitting enemies than when you're missing them, for obvious reasons. Anyway, with... That should work. Oh, that's everyone? It's not even half the... Okay, it's not even half the area, but I'll take it. 10 more shotgun shells. I have 56. Nice. So, with that... I think that the overall setup, it'd be interesting if, like I said, if they do something more than just you have two guns, you deal extra damage, you use more ammo, and you get to reload for free sometimes. Because yay! I mean, actually, to be honest, I think gun kata is a bit underrated as a master trait, but I do understand why it is given the reception it often gets, which is that it's okay, but... A lot of people who go for pistol builds tend to favor the technician one because it's just max damage at any range. And max damage when you have three levels of son of a gun, that's like 22 damage. And you have three levels of Eagle Eye, so you're likely to hit. So yeah, 22 damage pistol, that's definitely nice. However, I do still just like what gun kind of works. Because the thing is with the technician one, you can't have dual gunner and have the... What's the trick called? You gotta have to think about for a second what the trait is called. It was sharpshooter, that's it. So you can't have sharpshooter and dual gunner for obvious reasons. It would be terribly unfair if you could. I might as well go both. Yeah! My bad. Really should actually be more careful when running around like this, or literally be running around. That works too. I'm trying to think, but what's my move speed right now? 1 second. Ooh. The armor's putting me into the territory of most other classes. There you are. Thank you for revealing yourself. Hey, boots, nice. Oh, if I can aim on those. Ah, no. Help. Or just go away. Ah. All right, just don't die. Me? Oh, screw it. That sucks, but... It has to do, apparently. And now apparently I have to... Oops. Wanted to change to the other blue armor that's less cumbering, and also change my weapon out to the one that is the one I'm actually built for. Oh, hey, you. You die. See, that's a situation there with the demons, with the pinkies. That's a situation where Eagle Eye would have come in handy. Ah. Anyway, how many med packs do I have? One small med pack. Eesh. Yeah, I don't know if you'd notice. If you noticed, you probably have, that I'm using med packs on a specific hotkey. That's actually in the game by default. Although the default hotkey is Shift N and Shift M. Shift N for light, Shift M for heavy. I switched that around because I'm trying to do this setup where my mouse is on one hand, but yeah. Kind of works. It's nice to have. I never used them before, and I feel like just using them alone has massively increased my survivability. Oops. I would like to have hit that more often. Oh, boy. Oh, nothing here. Hey, two rocket launchers, too. That doesn't do me a whole lot of good, but I can get more rockets out of them. That's cool. Oh, double shotgun. Why not? Actually, wait, no, there is a good reason why not. That has a really long fire time, doesn't it? No, really long reload time. Might as well grab that. And apparently, are you... Is that seriously someone walking through lava? Some idiot walking through... Or not lava, acid. We aren't at lava yet. Anyhow. The... No. Cool. So I'm almost at level 4, which means I'm almost at Eagle Eye 1. Oh, Eagle Eye 1 and then Hellrunner. Just get the extra bit of accuracy right now. Point blank 91%. Not great. If I can get an agility mod, that'd be awesome. I could throw it on my boots and then be so much faster before getting Hellrunner, which I plan to get, but... You know, it'd be nice to have it before I... Ah. How dare you survive my assaults. Or my onslaughts. Hey, light amp goggles. Nice. Okay, so that's always useful. Hey! Another level complete without me dying. And actually, extra stuff to spare. Nice. Get that. Get to 100% health, because why not? Apparently run out of room in my backpack. Really? Yes, really. Okay. I'm tempted to drop the blue armor. I don't really expect to do a whole lot of armor modding. Alright, anyway. That's down to level 5. I have everything loaded. Yeah, everything's loaded. Bow, bow, bow. This really coincidental missing is working out nicely for me. Although, that being said, let's actually hit for once. What are my odds to hit anyway? 98%. It occurs to me, though, I thought Son of a Gun increases my ability to hit. Fire faster, deal one more damage. Maybe. It doesn't make that clear, though. It just seems like I fire them faster, not necessarily more accurately. Ah, don't want to hit that barrel. That would be a mistake. And I need to drop some ammo, apparently. I'll drop some shotgun shells. There's only 10 of them. Not a big loss. And if I'm as cautious as I have been so far, I'll probably end up using that quite quickly. Oh, that's nice. The speed. What is the speed anyway? 0.65. And slower than I'm used to. But it is still relatively efficient. Man, I'm kind of debating whether I should just get Son of a Gun 3 before getting Hellrunner. I feel like as long as I'm running well, especially if I get an A mod. If I get an agility mod, I might just not bother. Like, wait for a while for Hellrunner. Oops. And that's one. Nope. There we go. Because if I get Hellrunner now, that's I don't know, but on the other hand, moving away from enemies is always going to be a useful thing to do. If I end up in a group or dealing with pinkies, I will want to move away from them. And when that happens, Hellrunner could easily save my life if I don't have run ability or I'm using heavier armor. Okay, what's behind this door? Nothing behind this door, nothing behind this door. Oh, blue armor, ability to run for free. Yeah, it's a thing about globes. I've learned, actually read, sort of, the wiki page. Look at the mRL wiki. The description it has for globes, I believe it says something along the lines of, treat every globe as a free ticket to run. Like that, ow. Eh, whatever. I have a large one. No, I only have small ones. Shoot. I was right, though, about using it. Okay. Although, admittedly, that's two run opportunities that could have been mine. What is this? Water! Eh, could be worse. Could have been acid. Actually, if that was acid, I'd be dead. Maybe I should be a bit more careful about these things. Okay, what are you? You can't possibly be acid. No, your walls explode. Eh, whatever. It's safe. That's the time to do risky things like that. And I want to drop the armor I have, because you are blue armor. You are better blue armor than the blue armor I have. I shall pick you up and make you my own. And tuck you in at night. I'm not sure what I want to call you, though. Call you Rick. Sounds like a name armor would have. Is he destructible? I can't remember. They are! Good thing I checked. Well, neutral thing I checked, because I'm not really getting a whole lot out of it. I don't really need shell boxes that badly. I'm needing the shotgun less and less, so... I'm just gonna continue. Well, wait, no, hang on. Where's chain court? There's chain court. And this is gonna be the hard version chain court, too. Wish me luck. Oh, right, there's Hell Knights around here. Are you gonna... Oh, right, the stupid Hell Knights keep hiding in this one. Alright, so that's one. Okay, I've got to be careful. Hell Knight knockback will knock me into the lava. I do not want that. But I also don't want the Archvile Arena Master to get close to me. Die, you! Alright. That's the Hell Knight's gun. We need to kill some more mooks first. Before going to the Arena Master, I think. Because the Arena Master's a ways in. Okay, anyone here? You are here. What's my speed right now? 0.7? Okay. I can't really get the drop on anyone at that speed. This is what I mean by Hellrunner. Hellrunner could still be... Okay, that was my mistake. Hellrunner could still be very useful in this context. Alright, let's go back. And get the chainsaw! Drop some ammo and get the chainsaw! Yeah! Oh wait, you're gonna be a butt, aren't you? Alright, where's that archvile? Oh crap, I have no berserk anymore. Where the heck is that archvile anyway? It's gotta be here somewhere. I mean, it's a thing that this level has. It's the big thing about this level is that there's an archvile. And that's a pain in the butt, because it'll start rezzing if it hasn't already. It'll start rezzing everything. There you are, and now I have nothing to work with. Crap. I can't believe this didn't work out as well as it normally does. Normally, this works out beautifully. Why didn't this work? What the heck? This makes no sense. I've never had a chain court this difficult. Where I honestly wasn't sure if I would make it out alive. Well, I'm dead. That never happens! The chain court is never that difficult! What the hell? Where the heck was the stupid Arena Master? I can always just rush in and find it. And I just wasted that bloody run. And you know I've got to do that again, too, because... Like, seriously, my last run, I was able to get through all three Phobos things, no problem. I don't know why that's causing so many issues. Like, did I miss something and how to approach this? Should I just not bother with the chainsaw at all? I almost don't care anymore. After losing that run, I'm really pissed. Like, I'm really having a hard time caring. This... I'm so angry about that. Why did that kill me? How the heck did that kill me? The whole setup. Like, I had no berserk for any length of time that was useful. You know what? Forget it. Just forget the bloody side stages. Except maybe the one after seven. Just forget it. It's not worth it. I just want to win this bloody difficulty level. I'm so done with these side areas. Anyway, earlier I was talking about something to do with Jupiter Hell. Something to do with what was apparently going to be its mission system. No, not mission system. That is what's popping in my head, but that's not the thing that's relevant. Oops, pick you up. I don't remember what it was, actually. Well, that sucks. I can remember what it was, I'll bring it up again, but I don't remember. Like, I know that there was a plan to set it up like Aliens RL, where you have towers and everything, and there's a bunch of different spaces you can go. Ah, there we go. Broke a hole. Didn't want to really walk through acid. Bit of a risk, but it works. Like, oh right, dual wielding, that's what I was thinking of. Like how I was gonna handle dual wielding. And how I figure it's probably gonna do it in a way that's 21 shells. Anyway, I figure it's probably gonna do it in a way that is different. I can't imagine it'll just be reload. It might be choose multiple targets, it might be that you there's some defensive thing that you might get. I don't think you'd be able to like shoot. Well, okay, Scout probably wouldn't be shoot bullets out of the air level of defensiveness. That would be cool, but that seems like a thing the Technician would do, or possibly another class that doesn't exist yet, although I think the other classes that aren't in DoomRL are going to be just challenge classes that are possibly not even combat-oriented. Hey, armor! Didn't get this until quite a ways in last time. Oh, right, that's just what I wanted to do was... Wrong one. There we go. So, this point, I figure just a straight run. It's making me question whether I should actually have be going for Eagle Eye before Son of Gun 3. Or possibly even just dispensing with any additional traits until afterwards, but I don't know. The Eagle Eye thing has actually been working out for me historically quite well so far. Like, it has been a useful thing. That's 0.95. I think protective boots. I feel like protective boots slow me down a bit. Nope, they're fine. They actually have no effect. They're just straight up better. All right, cool. Strictly better. That's always wonderful. What is around here other than Berserk Pack, which is going to be handy? Where is everybody? Come on, does no one want to die? Come on, you demons. I'm sure some of you want to die. Do you want to die? Well, I hope so. Man, that would suck for you if you didn't. Let's continue. I don't want to die. So, I mean, I guess I can kind of sympathize, because, you know, I don't want to die, and I'm being kind of hypocritical by wanting them to die without dying myself. But, you know, I can only have one. Like, gotta make some choices. Sometimes you gotta make tough choices. Like, who lives and who dies? Like, I live and they die. That's pretty fundamental as far as I'm concerned. But maybe that makes me the bad guy. I'm never sure. Does that make me the bad guy? That I want to live rather than die? Went up against literal demons. From literal hell. Literally. Why did I pick you up? I don't want to pick you up. I want to unload you. Alright. Yes, I actually have pick up and unload down to the same button. Well, one of them with a shift modifier, but yeah. Okay. I want those light amp goggles and I want them bad. Like, bad enough that I'm gonna risk my own life. Somewhat. Not terribly risky, but you know, a little bit. Actually, no, I should've gone for Eagle Eye right there. I don't think I really need a dual gunner that desperately. I'm not gonna be switching to both pistols for a little while yet. Now I'm gonna switch, because that seems like a good time to switch when I have vision. Oh, you know what? Maybe it's not a good time to switch. I don't know. Are you there, shotgun guy? Yep. All right. Yeah, maybe I should be. Okay, I think next. Okay, I'll try Eagle Eye again. See how that goes. I mean, granted, I'm using light amp goggles, which somewhat tweaks it a bit. Like, it skews it a little bit towards long-range strategies, because normally I don't have vision like this, and I'm not going for cat eye, so I'm not going to have vision like this. Where? Okay, shotgun shells. All right, I think I have all the shotgun shells. Get a few more rounds. All right. That looks like about everything. Okay, what's over there, over to the northeast? There might be something cool. What's over to the northeast? Nothing great. All right, whatever. Back to the staircase. It's nice to have the mouse thing. Mice are nice. I mean, it's not great for when you're initially exploring, because it's both very risky and... Actually, no, I think it will go through the chained court. It's just CC plus is a pain in the butt. Vanilla chain court's trivial. It's free experience, really. Chain court plus, though, normally it's hard, but not... Like, I do everything in my power, and I thought it was going to work, and then I died. Ow. Fortunately, I was on the edge of that one, but yeah, ow. And I could use the experience. Especially if I'm going to go for a Master Trait plus some other stuff before the Master Trait. Like, where I normally go for Son of a Gun 3. But I don't know what I want to do. I have another green armor. I could use a med pack. I only have 4. Die. And you also preferably die. But make me question why I'm actually using this setup rather than having Son of a Gun 3 first. Yeah, I still feel like Eagle Eye is a good idea. Just because it does mean I hit more often, but it's like... If I hit with both, right now, it's 8 damage minimum, which isn't enough to kill most of these small enemies. Like, former humans and imps have 10 health. Plus whatever their armor gives them, but yeah, 10 health by default. And wow, that's a lot of ammo. There's a lot of light amp goggles, too. But yeah, they have 10 health by default, which means that if I have Son of a Gun 3 and Dual Gunner, and I hit with both shots, I kill them in one hit. But that's assuming that I have both of those things. Which isn't a safe assumption, actually. Because I don't always hit with Son of a Gun 3 and Dual Gunner. Alright, so I think the build will be Son of a Gun 3 after... Well, see about whether it should be after or before Dodge Master. That was really badly done. It was, like, really poorly done. That was a mistake. That was also kind of a mistake, but that was more just missing. But it does justify my early healing. But I think I should get Dodge Master first. But hold out on Gun... No, maybe I should just do Gun Kata and then do Son of a Gun 3. So I get the free reloads. Because the free reload is really handy. It doesn't sound like much, but it is really handy. Oof. All right, well. Run me! Oh, nice. Why'd you have to come? Darn it. See, this is where Eagle Eye is handy. I'm dead, aren't I? Because Eagle Eye would have allowed me to kill that in one shot, no problem. The other armor on. Shoot. Crap. Why are your enemies coming back here? Must you be here? Seriously. Go away. Yeah, see, this is what I mean. I probably shouldn't have gone for Dual Gunner this early. Probably should have gone for Eagle Eye first and then Dual Gunner. This really didn't do me a whole lot of good. Which one do I want to take? Actually, I can take both. But which one do I want to put on? Blue Armor. I value move speed a bit more. Not hugely, but enough. Okay, that was kind of a mistake. Yeah, so I think if I die and do it again, I'm gonna go for Eagle Eye before Dual Gunner. Because I think Eagle Eye after Dual Gunner is just a... It's not great. It doesn't seem to be optimal. It seems to be really risky. Like, I'm banking a lot on not getting hit before I manage to do useful things. And I mean, I was before making that bet using triple send of a gun, and that worked okay, because it was just more raw damage. But in those clutch situations where it really matters how you set that up, like, if I do Son of a Gun... Oops. If I do Son of a Gun 3, it's like, yeah, hits become more relevant because I could potentially one-shot more... Like, I could definitely one-shot assuming both hit. That assumes both hit, and I can't necessarily assume that. I usually one-shot if both hit right now. I mean, 2d4, that's 4d4. The minimum... Yeah, the minimum is 8. But the average... is like 13, no, not 13, the average is like 16 or something, so it's not that bad. Or sorry, what am I saying? No, the average is like 13. It's 8 to 20, because it's 2d4 plus 3. Sorry, plus 6, 4d4 plus 6. So the overall range is 8 to 22. So yeah, the average is about 16 or so. Or 15-ish. So generally, I'm gonna kill assuming both missiles hit. Both shots hit. Which is why I'm thinking, well, why don't I just go with Eagle Eye? Because Tormu suggested it, and I thought about it, and I realized, no, that's actually a pretty good idea. Because, like I said, I just deal more damage as a result. Do I want an armor shirt for this one? I feel like an armor shirt for that one's gonna be more relevant as time goes on. Oh, actually, now I come to think of it, maybe I should have done blue armor, because blue armor gets weaker if it gets damaged. Anyway, yeah, so with this setup... Man, I need more med packs. Ah, what am I... Wow, I am tired. I am evidently quite tired right now. Because walking into acid, not something I normally do. That was not anything to do with that script I was mentioning at the start of the stream. That was just me pressing buttons without looking at what was in front of me. I can't believe I did that. Well, if I throw the run away because of that, because that took so much damage off me and because I have no med packs left, I deserve that. I deserve that loss so much. Where the heck is that last guy? Okay, so as I was saying, yeah, hitting with the average damage I have, it might occasionally not be a one-shot, but it almost always will, and it's more likely to be a one-shot if both... Yeah, actually, oh yeah, that's how I worked it out. It's also why I'm going for Dual Gunner before Son of a Gun 3. I was thinking about the math of it, and it occurred to me that the math of it is that... I have an Empire suit back, don't I? Wow. Whatever, let's just go downstairs to the chained cord, get a bunch of berserk packs, that'll heal me up. I know, it's weird. This is actually a better strategy. Anyway, so... If you think of the math of it, the reason I'm going for Dual Gunner is because I'm going from 2d4 plus 3 to 4d4 plus... Well, sorry, 2d4 plus 2. It's not plus 3, I'm wrong. 6 to 20, that's the range. Wait, no, hang on. No, 8 to... Because it's 2d4 plus 4. That's what it is. Not 2d4, 4d4 plus 4. Which means, yeah, 8... No, they're right the first time. 8 to 20 is the range. 10 to 22 is the range if I have Son of a Gun 3. That makes more sense mathematically, which means the average is 14, I think. Yeah, 14 is the average. So on average, I deal 14 damage, and because of the distribution, that's almost always going to be within, like, 2 damage of the average. It's going to be enough to one-shot, assuming both hit. Now, if I go Son of a Gun 3, I'm only dealing an extra 2 damage. Or, sorry, extra 1 damage, because at that point it's 2d4. It's 2d4 plus 3. So every individual shot is 2d4 plus... Okay, how are we doing this? Every individual shot is going to go from 2d4 plus 2 to 2d4 plus 3, Son of a Gun 3. Which, yeah, when I get Dual Gunner means it's now 44 plus 6, which is nice. Or it could go straight to 2d4 plus... I'm sorry, 44 plus 4, ow, lava. Hence the Berserk Pack. That's why I get the Berserk Pack, because if anything like that happens, then it's less of a problem. Now I can get Eagle Eye and prove my points. Well, statistically, it will eventually prove my point. So the idea is that I double the damage, which it goes from a range of 4 to... 2d4 plus 2. 4 to 10 to one of 8 to 20. Which is massive. Compared to going from 4 to 10 to... Oh, you asshole. Ah, to 5... It'd be 5 to 11. I would just get Son of a Gun 3. Although, admittedly, the amount of damage I deal per second increases quite a lot with Son of a Gun 3, and that is actually where the difference really comes in. So individual shots make less difference... Okay, drop some ammo. Individual shots make less of a difference, but... No. Alright, first off, let's switch it off for green armor. It's pretty expendable. So you're done. Get another Berserk pack. No reason not to, I generally don't use them all anyway. Ha! And now back to shooting. So yeah, with... Because of that double damage, that's where Eagle Eye comes in. Because of Eagle Eye, I should be able to hit... I mean, point blank is essentially guaranteed hit, which is nice. Ah, this is gonna be risky. I don't want to rush in. There's a shotgunner. There's the... Okay. The idea with Eagle Eye is that it's more likely I'm gonna hit both shots at the same time. Should be everybody. Or very nearly. Bulk mod and power mod. Not ideal, but it'll work. Part of me wants to power mod my red armor. I feel like I should power mod one of my pistols instead. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do? Let's see. Use on weapon... So I'd like to do, although I don't have technical mods, which I usually use speed loader pistol. Oops, no. Use it on weapon. So I have one powerful weapon and one slightly better, or slightly larger magazine capacity weapon. The idea being that I could actually reload one weapon faster. So in really tight spots when I'm dealing with a lot of enemies coming at me, and this is why it's normally speed loader, is that I will use speed loader for one of the pistol that's in my main hand, and then I'll use the bulk for the offhand pistol. In this point, right now it's power and bulk, but the same idea is that the one in my offhand gets reloaded less frequently, or needs to be reloaded less frequently, so I can do main hand reloads just from shooting, and I have 2 extra bullets in the main hand. Now, it'd be nice to have 8 bullets in both, but it does mean that I can reload, do a faster reload and have it still pay off, and still be able to shoot a little bit of double shots. Oh, wow. All right, dead. I think as long as an enemy is within a couple tiles of me, I should be able to kill them, no problem. And if they're not, then I'll likely be able to kill them anyway. Ah. Yeah, it does seem like, in general, if I'm getting hit... Ooh. If I'm getting hit, I should be able to... And this is wonderful, the tracking map. I should be able to just use... What was I saying? Okay, if I'm getting hit... No, if I'm hitting them, I should be able to pretty much guarantee killing them. I mean, it's not an absolute guarantee. Like, it's not a mathematical guarantee, but it's so statistically likely that I feel like my earlier views on the way Son of a Gun 3 worked for one-shotting were a little misguided. Considering damage over time, actually, that was a situation where I wanted to use the faster reload. Considering damage over time, yes, Son of a Gun 3 is a clear winner because you attack much more quickly. Like, you attack 1.5 times more quickly. I would have an overall fire speed of 0.44 seconds a shot, which means that, yeah, I have an increase of 2-ish points of damage. That goes from 6 to 20 up to 8 to 22, big whoop. Or sorry, 8 to 20 get up to 10 to 22. So yeah, big whoop. But if you think about it, wait, is that right? No, like, that's not right. No. I'm wrong. 8 to 24 is the, 16 is the average. 8 to 24, and then 10 to 26 is what I would get if I got, wow, I am tired. Not mathing. That was 3d4 I was calculating, not 4d4. Anyway, now that we have the math sorted out a little bit more accurately. Ah. And that's the exact situation why I have a bulk modded pistol in my offhand. I mean, it'd be nice, like I said, it'd be nice to have two, but nah, this works out. This works too. Unload you. Oh. Okay, then never mind. I won't unload you. You know, maybe I should just switch out my armor. I mean, it occurs to me that this armor is unused. This armor, it is... I don't have enough room in my backpack? Really? I thought I dropped... Oh, I didn't drop you. Wait, no. I wanted to take off you. And then put on you, and then repair you, because I know blue armor is more valuable, but at the same time, I'm still not sure what I need for move speed, and more importantly, oh, this is going to be tough. Move you out of the way, so I actually need to blow this up. More importantly, I figure I just might as well get 100% blue armor. Like, no, I wanted to switch that, because I have the option of perfect blue armor. I don't need to use an armor pack on the blue armor. I can just replace it. So there's no real problem there. Anyway, yeah, so considering the math of it, if you consider that, like, okay, so it's 8 to 26 compared to 10 to 24, which is nice and all, but it's also not that great. Ooh, bulk mod. I don't think bulk mod's going to be useful on the pistols. Huh? Oh, I already have boots? Oh yeah, protective boots. What am I thinking? I'm good for boots. So if I use this on my weapon... No, I do not want a simple high power weapon. That's way too low capacity. Like, high power weapon is... Oops. High power weapon. High power weapon is... Yeah, magazine. The magazine drops down to 4. Actually, you know what? There are spare pistols. Why not? I think... I'm curious what it actually does. Use on weapon, yes. 2d6 with 4 ammo. Alright. Give that a shot. I mean, at this point, I'm actually dealing almost as much damage as I would deal if I was using the other thing I mentioned. That is the setup with... Eh, there we go. If I was using the setup I mentioned before with the Son of a Gun 3, although, yeah, what was I getting? Son of a Gun 3, so it would be... 2 extra damage, so average of 18 instead of average of 16 with that distribution, but it's also 1.5 times more frequent, so it's actually, in terms of time, closer to an average for like 25 damage, so it ends up increasing the damage considerably when you consider per time. So for enemies like demons, for instance, the amount of time it takes for them to approach me, that effectively increases, so in terms of just raw turn count. So when that's taken into account, it actually is much more useful to have Son of a Gun 3. But most of the time I find that in those situations, I'm probably going to reload anyway, so it's easier just to aim for really good... Okay, let's aim for really good one-shots. Rather than trying to go ham on... And there's that. Okay. One of the staircases, at least. Yeah, I find it's easier to just do good one-shots rather than trying to go ham on damage per second. At least at this stage. Once I get to the point where I'm fighting fewer imps and more arachnotrons and hell knights and such. And I heard a weird cry. Yeah, if I'm fighting more of the enemies that are basically a pain in the butt, then yeah. Okay. What was tactical mod pack again? I don't know what that one does. It's fire time, armor knockback resistance. Ooh. Armor knockback resistance is tempting, but I really want an agility mod for my armor. Actually, do I know of anything for boots that's AT? No, nothing I'm aware of. Yeah, well, you know what? Oh, yeah. Modify boots. I now get less knockback. Okay, well, that's Hell Knights. I can deal with those. Yeah. Yeah, so dealing with heavier enemies, I can definitely see the value in Son of a Gun 3. As I'm sure will be relevant very shortly. But right now, I think I'm going to focus on running, on movement. Because that is always the weakness of this build, is approaching enemies in the first place. And, ooh, that looks like a nice shotgun. Okay, see ya. Also goes off, assault shotgun. Well, why not? Assault shotgun. I have like 200 shells, don't I? Yes, I have exactly 200 shells. Well, 201, because that assault shotgun was... No, 206! Ooh. Neat. Okay, is that Phobos Lab or military base? Military base. Might as well do it. I've only died once in military base, and that's because I got super careless. Now, granted, it's already been established this stream that I'm actually pretty careless right now. I have gone and nearly gotten myself killed just because I decided walking into acid was a perfectly good idea. Rather than the stupidest thing I could have done. Seriously, what was I thinking? Oh, I'm dealing enough damage I can actually break those boxes. Nice. Okay. I'm not even gonna do this the risky way. Oh, nice! This is a tactical shotgun! Are you doing anything else? No, no one else. And an A mod! Are you gonna work on my boots? No. Shoot. Alright, well, switch you out for the high power pistol, kill you, and then supercharged globes, why not? Where'd those other boots go? There were other boots. There they are. Because I figure I can drop some more ammo, pick these up, switch them out. No. Tab. There we go. And then agility mod these boots. And if I agility mod the boots, that'll be a nice boost to movement speed. I mean, I could agility mod armor. It's just armor tends to break much more frequently, so I don't like modifying it too much. Unless I'm building an assembly right there. Now, granted, I could build ballistic armor, whatever. If it was fireproof, I'd be more keen. Like, fireproof blue armor is nice, because I think it keeps its plasma resist, because blue armor by default is very plasma resistant. I think you keep that and add fire resistance, but I don't remember for sure. Anyway, mod boots. That should, yeah, 0.9. Back to scout speed. But yeah, boots almost never break. It's very difficult to lose your boots. All right. So yeah, the thing is, boots, you might as well mod them if you're trying to do things like speed stuff or just for modification purposes. For assemblies, yeah, do it on armor. But I'm not planning on making an assembly with that anytime soon. Although, admittedly, I have... I might as well do the military base anyway. Free experience. I know I said no more red staircases, but... These are easy. It's really Hell's Arena that causes things to become a real pain in the butt. Now, I've got to think about this. Okay, so I'm up to level 5, and this is a dungeon level 7, which means that at this point, I don't even know if I'm going to get gun kata. Well, no, the amount of experience, normally I get gun kata around Daimos level 5. And if I get something other than Hellrunner, it's going to be possibly hell by the time I get there. And I currently have a setup where reloading immediately is extremely handy because of the high-power pistol. Like, you don't have a whole lot of shots per clip. So being able to go without reloading for a while is going to be handy. This does increase... You know, I think I'll go with Hellrunner. I might get Son of a Gun before I finish up the main build. But I'm not gonna... Oh, darn it. But this already puts me into near running speed without running. Okay, so to the left, or to the right, rather, not to the left. In fact, I can't close... Oh, shoot, I can't close the doors. Oh, I see. I need to take this out of here. Then drop it, and then I can close the door. I just want them behind me. It was a thing I didn't do last time, and it's not a bad idea to just generally do. So, I'm expecting to see some elites pretty soon. I mean, if I don't make it through this section, then, I mean, what the heck. Making it through this section is basically key. Because you get so much out of here. You get a tracking map. There you are. Ow, that was actually slightly painful. And there's another one that came down here, wasn't there? Not a sergeant, mind you. It was one of the former humans. There you are. Elite former human. Alright. I think this is kind of the traits kind of a thing. Question of whether I want to go with reliable. Oops, wow. Oh shit. Let's pick that up. Yeah, so the question is, do I want to go with reliable fast damage? Like, just being able to do damage without having to worry about whether I'm... Ooh. Well, let's stick with blue armor. Actually, no, wait. There's no point. The green armor. Actually, there's no point in this either. Put this on. Drop this. I'm going to get green armor. I might as well get slightly... less damage. Okay, that wasn't actually that great. Ow! Ah, that hurts. Ow! Okay, get the other one here. Okay, that's getting really close for comfort. All right, let's get the tracking map, and that should be everything for the really scary bits. That's the really scary bit. Like, if anything goes wrong, it's gonna go wrong there. Everything else from this point on is gonna be relatively simple. But yeah, I guess I'm kind of noticing the fact that I don't have Son of a Gun does mean that I have to be more careful about how I shoot. And the exact timings I have for all this stuff. Oh, right. That doesn't help me any. Because if I'm taking too... Because I'm taking longer to shoot now, which means that, of course, I'm... Well, having to stop in between shots more frequently. Which isn't great. Because if I'm stopping between shots, then that means that I'm just... When I'm stopping between shots, I have to shoot less before I start taking cover. Okay, forget it. Let's just go back to the assault shotgun. Shotguns are best for clearing boxes. And this is why this area, once I get through the one section, it's fine. Because there's so many med packs here. That, and this is where all the elite farmers are. Okay. All right, that's it for med packs. So, back to high power pistol. But yeah, with this. Aha! You're gonna die. You're gonna die. I mean, I realize there are some elites over to the other side, but nah, I don't care. Oh, that tracking map. That is kind of high risk, high reward. You go in that section first, you get the tracking map. It's a bit trickier than this. Like, there's more cover here. But you get a tracking map. And it provides so much. Almost level 6, too. That's actually... that's something. I didn't realize I was that close to level 6. I don't think I'll get it before I get through Phobos Anomaly, but I keep it on. Alright, Leech... Oh, shit. Man, you're a pain. I still have some med packs left. So drop this. I have no attachment to it. Oops. What am I doing? Blue armor. Maybe I should have just gone for the red armor this whole time. I mean, I'm just thinking, you know, the amount of damage I'd be taking, or I wouldn't be taking, if I had the extra protection. But yeah, see, this is what I mean. Granted, I know where they are, so that helps a lot. But if I didn't know where they are, I'd probably just radar shoot my way through this. And there's my level 6. All right. This is a really tough choice. Part of me wants the extra damage. Actually, no, I will take the extra damage. Hellrunner's all well and good, but the Bruiser Brothers are this exact sort of enemy that I want the extra damage to deal with. It doesn't mean I won't get gun-cotta for a while, but you know what? I think it'll be fine. That's ballistic armor. I need bulk. What if I use this? No, it has to be steel boots. Shoot. What happens if it's technical? What do I get for technical? Nothing. Oops. Alright, well, that was a bit disappointing. So, what do I have in total? I have a bunch of ammo. Actually, very little of everything. I can hold these. How about that? And I have a decent amount of shells. I am using that shotgun quite a bit, so I might want to keep some shells. Of course, is there anything else I'm missing? No, there's that. There's that little... There's the large health globe that I don't really care about too much. There's the armor that's damaged. I don't have enough room for it anyway. Med packs and parasuit packs. Oh, those mod packs. Those are coming super handy. I almost feel like I should have tried a ballistic mod armor before coming down here. Given how hard it turned out to be. I mean, I feel like now it's going to be a lot easier because I have Eagle Eye and I have my normal setup for speed. Because now it's like I have my normal setup for fire speed. I've got a relatively typical for me setup for movement speed. Yeah, I'm pretty comfortable with this setup. All right, well, might as well go with this at first and then get the backup red armor later. I want to drop you. I want to drop you. I need you. And then I think... What's this shotgun? What is this fire speed anyway? 1 second. Not great. I mean, scouts do get a slight bonus. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. All right, got out of there. Back to high power pistol. I do have... Yes, okay, good. I'm doing the duel. There we go. Wow, that was... See what I mean? Like, what I'm used to is stuff not shooting back at me. And that's what you get from Son of a Gun. Actually, are we still... Are there still stuff... I think there's still cacodemons. Yes, there are. Although that does mean I don't have to be point-blank range in order to deal meaningful damage, so that's nice. Now, I don't need you. Oh. Really? Oh, right, because I used the large med pack. Screw you. 10% green armor is not worth it. And am I low on ammo at all? No. Nah, I'll be fine. I think I'll grab it anyway, just to be sure, but... I can't imagine any real problems. Also, just reload you, just to be sure. Just to be on the safe side. I mean, I'm probably gonna be fine. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do this thing. Kite my way back. Which I know sounds weird, because I'm doing an ostensibly pistol-based build. But shotguns are just that useful. Okay, now I need to switch. Yeah! That was all double shots. And I did not die. And I have bed packs to spare. And I have this large health globe. And I can probably pick up these... Oh, I can't pick up the rockets. Well, nah. I can pick up the rockets now. It could come in handy when I find a rocket launcher. I don't know when that'll be. I had 3 in the last run, so I guess that's my next 2 runs worth of rocket launchers. Why are you doing that? All right. So, we're in Deimos, and I have... Wow, I'm halfway to level 7, which means halfway to the next Hellrunner level. And then, yeah, so at this point, I think... Assuming I don't... Oops. Oh, tracking maps. What joy! It is such luck to get tracking maps all this time. Ow. Alright, you're done. And Barons, of course, but hey, tracking map. So do I care. Actually, how am I going to do this? Because I almost feel like I want to go in opposite direction. Like, there we go. Oh, wait, that's acid. That was possibly a mistake. Now I'll be fine. Only possibly. Not in actuality. There we go. Need to light up goggles. I am now lit. Whatever that means. I actually don't know what that slang term means. It means something, I just don't know what it is. Ooh, Hell's Armory. Ah. No. I think no. I think that'd be a bit too much of a risk. Although, admittedly, I'm not in a bad position for it, but... Can I just knock back a Baron using pistols? I guess that is a thing, actually, but... Still... How many Barons are there? Okay, there's another couple Barons. Sheesh, all the Barons. So if I go over here, if I go in this doorway, I'm going to be hit. If I go right here, I can get some free shots off. Just use a phase device on me. Oh, good, Baron. I was worried that the Baron behind would see me, and actually, it doesn't see me, but it did get its attention by shooting at it. Ow. Get over here. There we go. So that's all the Barons done. It's nice to be able to hit at ridiculous ranges. My chance, still 98. So my initial guess about how things work regarding Son of a Gun were correct. You don't get extra range, or you don't get extra accuracy. You do, however, get extra damage and you shoot faster. Most importantly, you shoot faster, which for things like Barons of Hell is so important. Which is why I'm going for it, even though it's kind of awkward, but yeah, I'm going for it for that reason. If I can get Threat Armor alive... Oh, bulk power. Oh, you know, I could have made a nanofiber armor off of what I had in the enchained court. I didn't even think of that. I mean, I don't regret what I have in terms of weapons. It's just that I could have made nanofiber armor. But I can't remember if nanofiber red armor gives you only one. I think it only gives you 1 point of armor. I think nano-modded red armor is potentially 4 points of armor. But nano-fiber red armor is always 1 point. You just happen to get the resistances and move speed penalties. And I think there's also a knockback bonus. No, fire resistance is the only bonus. All right. So I can A-mod my armor. I don't think I could really meaningfully A-mod my... Actually, wait. I have tactical pack. I can make a speed loader pistol. I don't know if I want to, but I could. I could also... Oh, you know what I could do is agility mod this. Because I have been using it so much and I want... Oh. That agility mod changed the fire time. Oh, accuracy. Technical mod increases fire time. Shoot. That was a waste. You never need accuracy for shotguns. It's a shotgun. It's always going to hit. Ah, I should have read the description. That was a mistake. That was a pretty big mistake, actually. Because the fire time thing was the one thing that made the assault shotgun questionable as my backup strategy, but yeah. Well, you know, who knows what I'll get inside that, inside the armory. But I think this will be it for red staircases. Wait, what do I have for small, large? It's doable, but risky. As long as the arachnotrons don't get me. Should be fine. As long as I shoot down the corridor. Hey, nice, level 7. I can get Hellrunner. Which means my move speed is now effectively running speed by default. Yeah. Okay, let's actually go in for real now. After replenishing all that ammo, I just shot into the ether, hoping for the best. Actually, I must have. How many shots did I take? I'm really low on ammo, actually. Or, well, not low. 354 bullets isn't that low. But I was, like, rocking 500 something. Ooh. That's why I don't mod armor too much. I'm going to be swapping out its red armor as soon as I get the chance, unless I get a way of healing the armor. Oh, you know, I can get a rocket launcher here. Of course, the only reason to do that would be to go into the wall, and that's further breaking my promise of not taking red staircases. It's like, by not taking red staircases, what I meant was take every single red staircase in existence. As I'm sure you knew. Ooh, fire... Ooh, wait. Ooh, armor. Would be worth it, though. Fireproof armor is super handy. I might as well go for it. Fireproof blue armor. Should I have my mod boots? Can't. Okay. Fireproof. And then I want to use the... Is it technical? Oh, wait. What was the other one? Fireproof. Crap, I screwed that up. Power mod of the blue armor. I meant to technical mod the blue armor, and then bulk mod the blue armor, which I couldn't do. Wait, what can I get for power mod, though? No, we established that that's not possible. Okay, never mind. That sucks. Let's get some rockets, at least. So, what am I thinking? What do I have right now? I have this unmodded, but I can't mod. I don't have WizKid. Everything in my inventory is modded, except the chainsaw, which I'm not going to mod. I could mod some of the red armor to try to make fireproof red armor, but meh. I I feel like plasma is going to be a bit more handy going forward, so... Ah, I kill you all. Subtle knife, so not a combat knife. I don't think I've seen it before, so I will pick it up just to have the recognition of having picked it up. Looks very inconspicuous. A weapon that can cut through the very fabric of reality. Too bad it's only 8 inches long. Oh. What does alt fire do? Okay. That seems like a mistake. I don't need you anyway. Where was the thing I dropped? I dropped this, I think. Perfectly in good condition blue armor that I could have modded instead. That sucks. I mean, I still can. But I can only make ballistic armor at the moment. I bulk mods. But I can't remember what you need to do in order to make the mods show up near the end. You have to pull that switch and kill the Shambler, but I can't remember beyond that what you have to do. Okay, that's everyone. Speaking of Shamblers, I actually found this thing for Quake that I'm sure other people have noticed that makes it work in... Well, it's this engine mod that makes it 360-degree field of vision, or 200-degree with a nice projection to it. But it's interesting playing a game in Mercator projection. I mean, it seems like a sin against cartography, because the Mercator projection is. But, you know, that being said, it's still pretty cool. Alright, now I gotta figure out where the heck you are. I mean, I was actually using hammer projection, which is basically the same thing. So, for those of you not familiar with the Mercator projection, go look at an atlas. Especially one that you might find in elementary school. If you don't have access to elementary school, then I don't think you really need one. But yeah, most popular maps use the Mercator projection. And that, it's generally considered to be... Did I do that without damage? No, I took damage. I took damage. I got hit. I didn't get splashed or anything, but I got hit. Darn, I thought I was hoping I would actually do that completely clean. Oh, well. Hey, mods! Oh, Firestorm. Hey, bulk mod. I mean, I can make a fireproof blue armor, but first, I can make nanofiber armor. And why not? No! It is only one. Oh, well. What does Firestorm do? I don't think I've ever seen one of these. Increases shots by 2 for rapid and blast radius by 2 for explosive. So it doesn't do anything for the weapons I have. But I'll keep it in case I get a rocket launcher. Drop the ammo. I only have 400 ammo, but oh well. Might as well get some spare blue armor. What can I drop for armor? 2 red armor packs. Don't really want to drop those. Yeah, I think I know what I'll do. I'll mod the blue armor to have some agility. I know it's not going to become, if I do that, it's not going to be any way useful for what I want. That is, for ultimate... Oh, no, no, wait. It's technical bulk, right? It was technical bulk? Yes. I could just tech mod it. That works. Nope. Cancel. Wanted to drop the technical pack and pick this up, then switch it over to then use the technical pack on the armor, so that I'm halfway there. I only have 2 med packs, though. That's kind of disconcerting. I don't think I lost too much here, though. I feel like this is one of the better Hell's Armories I've done. I might as well pick some of those up. Awesome. So all the ammo that I have is full. I have some spare armor. Quite a lot of spare armor, actually. Even if it isn't the best type of spare armor. And... shoot. Oh, wait. Right. I've got plenty of firepower. And an invulnerability globe. And the ability to go berserk. I like going berserk. It heals me. Okay, you're gonna die. So, what's my current speed? 0.63. Yeah, I don't really need a modded armor that much. Oh, why must you make me choose, game? Well, actually, I guess that does make sense, because if it makes me choose, then I have to make meaningful decisions, and as a result, have a more interesting experience on account of the meaningful decisions, making my run my own rather than simply being carbon copy of whatever anyone else does, and also being highly solvable, which would defeat the purpose of a roguelike. So fair enough. That being said, I do kind of want to keep this. I do kind of want to keep these A-mods. Actually, no, I'm just going to A-mod one of these red armor packs. Even though I'm not going to use it very much, I'm just going to do it. Because what else am I going to agility mod? Most everything in my inventory is basically what it's going to be. I don't really intend to add a whole lot, and... Okay, that's about it. I don't really intend to change up a lot of what I'm doing, although I could... No, I only have one of our suits back, never mind. Ooh, a revenant! That's actually really fortunate that I found a revenant right at that exact moment. Because I have the invincibility! And it's only fortuitous that I happen to find it at that specific moment. Oh, that's water. That's why. It's like, wow, that's really undamaging acid. I guess invulnerability makes you not care about that. Not really. But water is just water. It's not a big deal. I don't hear any revenants around. Which is good, because revenants are a pain in the butt to deal with. Especially for a pistol build, but in general, although I have the assault shotgun, so I don't have to deal with them in the silly way I tried to deal with him last time. Ah, screw it, blow you up. Barrels are there for a reason. Not just to break things, but also to kill enemies. I just am reluctant, because they tend to break items. And if I'm not careful, put lava all over the ground. Okay, Son of a Gun 3 is really handy. I don't regret getting the Eagle Eye, mind you. But I do feel like I'm not hitting that often, but then again, it's only 1 point of Eagle Eye. So, I'll take it. It's my, 98% two hit point blank. Definitely better accuracy than I generally have. I mean, I guess I could agility mod pistols, but I don't have WizKid, so not happening here. Ooh, nice, I have room. How did I get room? Oh, I'm running low on ammo, that's how I got room. I want to be careful about that, actually. He says as he shoots lost souls with bullets, despite the fact that they have resistance to bullets. Alright, well, let's stop being silly then, and do things the efficient way. What is this? The wall! I do not have a rocket launcher! Wow! I don't have a rocket launcher! How late in the game is this and I don't have a rocket launcher? This is annoying. I can't go to the wall. Well, I guess I'm keeping my promise regarding anything to do with red staircases. So, 310mm, 193 shotgun. Oh, I kind of want to get some more 10mm. I feel like I'm starting to run. I might run low pretty soon. I'm not careful. What? No, pick you up. Because 10mm is my bread and butter. If I don't have that, I'm going to die. Or, at least, gonna have a hard time. I have, okay, the shotgun shells, 360, that's pretty good. I can get a bit more. All right, so, this point, Deimos level 3. Oh, sweet, is it just another demon maze? Yeah, it's another pinky maze. Nice, this is really, really efficient. Although, I'll grant, Revenants and Mancubi don't become an issue until I get to hell. And then I'm in hell. And then it's just hell. It's pretty apt, really. 0.6? Oh yeah, Hellrunner 2. What am I thinking? Of course it's 0.6 per move. Ooh, nice, I can get this red armor fully, well, almost fully healed up. This was handy. This is a productive stage. And I get more head med packs. Eventually, maybe. Where are the rest of the demons? I'm not the demons, before anyone asks. There are the demons. And now there are no more demons. Goodbye, demons. You can go burn in hell. Wait, why do I have protective boots again? Like, tech mod or protective boots? I don't see the point. But no. First off, drop you. I do see the point of A-modded, but not agility-modded, but not tech-modded. And the Firestorm Weapon Pack is starting to seem less and less useful as time goes on. I keep getting areas like this, these 10mm ammo is going to get more and more valuable. Nah, I'm not going to need the chainsaw. I know I went through all the trouble of getting it, but really, that was almost just to heal up that whole area. Okay, Deimos level 5, and I'm almost at level character level 8. And a rocket launcher! Which basically just takes the spot in my inventory that was currently reserved for the Firestorm pack. What? What? Oh yeah, I can't. Good point. Upgrade my weapon. Nice. So, Firestorm, Modded Rocket Launcher. Oh, crap. And this is where the Assault Shotgun comes into play. Ow! Ow, ow, thank goodness I have fire resistance. Okay, all right. Still here, still standing. Did lose the armor pickup, but the red armor is in decent position, in decent condition anyway. And gothic boots. Oh crap! I don't remember how these work. And I'm never gonna find out. Thanks, plasma guy. I was curious. I mean, I think they massively reduce your move speed or something like that, so it wouldn't have been the best thing in the world, but I wanted to know. Okay. I still wanted to know what was gonna happen. Just didn't. Oh wait, I've got plenty of med packs. Let's just not die? How about we don't die? That sounds as good to everyone else as it does to me. Wow, how many shotgun shells did I use? Oh, I see. Right, I used a med pack, which would help. Sort of. Okay. Red armor's still in decent enough condition, but not- Oh, never mind. It's in good condition. We're good! We have more red armor. More super fast armor. Super fast, super tough armor. Which probably saved my butt with that Mancubus encounter. As in, it did save my butt with the Mancubus encounter. That's the only way I survived that. Oh wait, how many? Nah, 10 rockets. Shoot. Yeah, that was pretty scary. I don't like this hallway. It's open, and I just made lava barrel happen. Ow. Well, use one of you. Pick up the other one. Eh, whatever. And get more light. I want to see what's happening. Which means I can do this. Oh no. Where's the Mancubus? There's the Mancubus. Can I kill it in time? No. Well, I can kill it without it hitting me, so that's something. Seriously, that's gonna be one of the biggest challenges I can think of for this game. Play it without sound. And it's actually kind of funny because there are actually quite a few little amenities for people who are blind who want to play Doom the Roguelike. Which is nice. I mean, you know, people are blind. Some people. And why should that stop them from playing a video game, especially one as good as this one? So definitely in favor of that. It's just, it's interesting that if you're blind, it's not so bad. There's a lot of ways to play if you're blind, but if you're deaf, man, that's gotta suck. Also, ow, my armor. I've got time if I drop a level to use another med pack, and there's nothing here, is there? There's a phase device. Oh, you know what? No, I'm gonna get that phase device. That phase device could be a lifesaver. And I might as well just use the med pack in the process. Seriously, phase devices, especially in this stage, if I find myself, I go down the steps and all of a sudden I'm in this terrible situation, which fortunately this time I'm not. Salt shotgun. But now I am. So let's say that happens, or something worse. Also, why am I going at that? Alright. My power pistol. Still playing the gun kata setup. Alright. Darn it! I don't think that'll lock anything out, but... No, it locks out that. Actually, it doesn't totally lock it out. I should be able to rocket launch my way through that, come to think of it. No. Yes. Ow. There we go. I don't remember exactly what the firestorm did to it. It was something like it made it stronger or something. All right, I need to run. Hey, more armor bits. Oh boy. Those shoot acid. I think that counts as acid damage. And that's a very hard damage to get resistance for. Oh boy. Ah, crap. Please let me get the armor shard. Blast steel boots. I think those are just... I think those resist something other than these ones, because the protective boots resist acid. I think the red plasteel boots resist. Oh, they resist acid a lot and fire somewhat. And have aim mod. Agility modded plasteel boots. That seems like a good idea. In case I get knocked into lava or something. What was this noise? Well, I can't remember what that noise is. Not a revenant. I think it's lost souls? I can't remember what that noise is. No, it's not relevant. I can't get... Oh, I can. It's just... Stand clear! Eh, screw it. I don't care what's inside that. Just kill the bastards. Oh! Cacodemons! Ow. Let's not use this in here. I can't remember exactly what the rules are for splash damage. And I can kill these no problem without being too close. If I wasn't careful, I could have blown myself up very easily right there. Nice, med pack. You know what sucks? No med globes, or health globes, or whatever they're called. Oh boy, wow. Yeah, I haven't gotten a lot of health globes recently, and that's been bugging me. But wow, was it ever a relief to have that happen. Hey, what's this? Halls of Carnage. I have never gone there. I'm kind of curious what it is. Most of me doesn't care. How bad could this be? That's not so bad. All right. I am invincible! Might want to change my armor, though, because... I'm out of agility mods, so I can't easily get more agility modded red armor. Oh, crap. Actually, wait, no, this is perfect. Although, I guess it doesn't matter, because I think invulnerability lasts... I think it's based on your turn count, not based like the amount of times you hit buttons to move. Ah, oh, crap. Where is that annoying thing? It's so... Oh, crap. All right. Actually, that was a relatively painless archvile encounter. Those things are a pain in the butt. If they get you... Well, I mean, they're throwing their arms in the air and trying to get you, and it's just a pain in the... It's just hard. They kill you. That's what they do. They come up to you, and they raise their arms up, and then you blow up. Granted, I'm moving fast enough, I should be able to dodge it, but still, it's... No, don't want to deal with that. Four rockets, and there's a revenant around here somewhere. I don't remember where. And there's that stupid barrel that I can't deal with. Oh, crap. I just need to find a way of fighting it in a way that I have cover. Just open that door. I don't want the lava barrels. Because if I have the lava barrels, then it really limits my movement. Wait, salt chucking. The time to use a salt chucking is now. Okay, and also the time to switch over to my other armor is now. Actually, wait. Oh, salt can just fully load. Okay, good. Ah! There we go. Perfect. Let me at him! Where'd the guy go? Why do whenever I get the invincibility, I can't find the revenant? There you are. Ah, crap, invincibility's bad enough. Okay, that was a bit of a risk. I'm sorry I'm not speaking as much. I'm getting really focused. I should probably start talking a bit more. But anyway, the revenant, yeah. It's going to be mainly revenants I go into serious mode for, because seriously, revenants. No joke. Oh, wait, what am I doing? Just kill you. Now my blue armor's damaged. Great. Which would have become fireproof armor, which would have been really handy for dealing with you, and... No, let's do this with the red armor. That red armor is super important to me. Agility modded red armor is like effectively no move speed penalty. That's too good to pass up. Bit risky because I only have one shot, but that works. Anyway, yeah, that's really good. I don't want to pass that up if I don't have two. Is there anything over here? Yes, there is an imp. Another imp. What's my move speed right now? 0.44. Nice. I shoot as fast as I move. So one more level. So the next level, Cyber Demon. Oh, I've got to be careful about that, actually. I think of it. I mean, I can theoretically deal with Cyber Demon without getting hurt. Ooh, more agility mod packs. Getting a lot of those. And they're what I generally want. I'm just thinking of what I want to do with that, though. Because at this point, I think everything I care about... Yeah, everything I care about has been modded. Everything in my inventory, except for one red armor, has been modded. And if it comes down to it, I can mod it no problem. So I'm not going to worry about it too much. All right. Did I miss any orbs? Possibly. Don't know what's in there. But yeah, the Cyber Demon theoretically won't damage me if I do it right. But it still takes about 25 shots to kill it. Like, at maximum, but it takes at most 25 shots to kill it, which sounds weird because I'm saying at most, and, it, like, why does that matter? Because I don't know exactly whether or not I'm going to be able to kill it efficiently. I don't need this. I need this far more. basically, the reason is the amount of reloads I have to do. And with this setup, it's a little trickier because I have every four shots, I have a fast reload. And then every eight shots, every second set of four shots, I have a slow reload. And I also want to have the fireproof armor because that's... Or not the fireproof, the red armor, because that'll at least help a bit. Because that is better fire resistance and... Oh, no, it's not better than anything else. Okay, better fire resistance. That's something. That's a thing. It matters. I reached the Tower of Babel. What's my current move speed? It is 0.6. Okay. I think he fires like once every 2 seconds or something. Okay, good. I found him in a less open area. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ah, too close. Three, dodge. 1, 2, dodge. 2. Ow, what? Shoot. Where's my other armor? Other red armor. Not the place I want to be. 1. This thing is a... Basically, I have roughly one free shot after every... What? Shit. After every shot, I get one free. And at this point... Ah, this is the best one, then. Gonna have to be careful. What? Reload again. Okay. That's been... Damn it. Okay. What's my other... Damn it, they're both empty. Okay. 2, 3, 4. There we go. There we go! Okay. And I get Gunkata. Nice. The very end of demos, but I did it. Alright. So, I mean, Gunkata doesn't do me any good in that fight anyway, so I'm not too concerned that I didn't have it for that. Alright, let's take stock. I have a red armor that's heavily damaged, blue armor that's heavily damaged. I lost a red armor in the process, but that was not A-modded. So, that's good. And 288 ammo, or 288 pistol ammo, 100 shotgun shells, 10 rockets, loads of space, and 1 med pack. And I'm in hell, where the demons are careless. And forget that lava burns. Lava is hot. Just public service announcement out there. For all those of you who were considering a career as a lava diver, may I remind you, lava is hot. Very hot. As in, you will not survive hot. Apparently even the demons of hell do not survive. And if the demons of hell can't survive, and they're from hell, what chance do you have? This public service announcement was brought to you from hell. Okay. This is tempting. I don't have any other technical mod packs. Wait, what am I saying? Just take it. I have room. I can just take it. I can have it in my inventory. It's no problem. Hey, more armor packs. Sweet. Back up to full. Well, let's go with red armor. Let's go from almost surviving things to actually doing well. And what? Ooh, what are you? A mega spear. Oh, sweet. Armor and health. That is ideal. Not sure why I got that, but whatever. Yeah, this is working out nicely. I'm recovering pretty well. And I have a rocket launcher so I can get into here if I so choose.
I am seriously considering whether I should, because two arch files. Yeah. And not much else, really. So I've got to think to myself, I have my full build. I've got basically a pretty comfortable but not particularly safe position to be in, just in terms of my inventory. I'm at 200% health, which is nice, but I'd also have to deal with a revenant, an archvile, so that revenant might be coming back. Two archviles, actually, so the archvile might be coming back if I don't give it, which no guarantees because I don't plan to use a rocket launcher. Actually, you know what? How many rockets do I have? 66, huh? Unfortunately, I don't know what the resistance on revenants is for rockets. I'd imagine it'd be relatively high. But if you think about the other stuff, how much do I care about this area? I mean, the first question is, how much do I care that I would not be getting 100% kills? Okay, first off, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So I'm still on track for 100% kills, if I so choose. Oh, and there's staircases in there. All right, never mind. The decision has been made for me. Right. Well, first things first, unload the rocket launcher. Stand back and fire. And keep firing, because screw all y'all. I don't want to deal with this crap. Actually, come to think of it, the archvile just decided to go off. All right, cool. You do your own thing. I won't worry about you then. Oh, right, the Arena Master is a particularly long setup for that. Oh, shit! Damn it. I don't want to deal with this. Okay, good. One arch fell down. That's what matters. Revenant down! Awesome! And I can get more rockets. Although, this actually worked out better than I expected. My armor took some damage, but I was mega-sphered, and it's also got resistance and such. So... let's get rid of the fodder enemies, just for now. Oh, right, a gun caught it. What am I thinking? I'm getting reloads for free. Ow. Okay, phew. The real threats are dead. All that's left is fodder. And my own potential stupidity. How much do I have for ammo? I have a healthy amount of ammo. I have a healthy amount of health. One of you's not dead. You're being really frustrating there. All right. That went well. That actually went remarkably well, I've got to say, for how much I was dreading going in there, and I am still good for 100% kills. Although I kind of doubt I'm actually going to be able to fulfill that. Probably won't need these. I realize I just got through an area because I happen to have enough rockets to make it work. But seriously, the main threats I encountered at this point are all rocket-based anyway, so I've got plenty of rockets to come my way. Two phase devices. I'm still in a good spot that way. Level 2 of hell! That was just level 1! Hey! Oh, crap. Oh, wait, gun caught it. Thank goodness I got gun caught it. That just saved me a bunch of... ow. I'm not gonna risk death that easily. But that saved me a... that saved me my life, actually. That would have... or maybe not my life, but it certainly made living a lot easier. I mean, let's be honest, had I not had that with the enemies that close to me, that could have easily been the end of the run. Can it hit me? Ow, yes. Yes, the answer is yes, it can. All right, where's the way into that room? I'm not sure in which game, this or the original Doom, archviles are more annoying. Because archviles are that annoying. I really don't know which one's worse. I mean, in this game, you can kind of dodge them a bit, but... I mean, you can kind of dodge them in both. Actually, I find probably this game they're a bit more annoying. Because unless you have enough actual move speed, you can't dodge them. Like, you literally cannot dodge them. Also, what are my boots like? 100%. Ugh. I feel like I'm not going to make much use of this. At least not for now. My red armor, no... Hey, bulk bat. I can have nearly broken bulk armor that doesn't really do me a whole lot of good. Yay. I mean, I could... Well, you know what? Maybe it'd be fine. What happens if I do this? Yeah, fireproof armor. Oh! Oh, okay. I get it fully equipped. Nice. I don't think I need this right away. I don't hear any revenants. Yeah. But yeah, the fireproof armor, that's nice to have. I don't have any armor that has any more defensive power than 2 right now, so whatever, we'll go with it. Power mod do me any good right now? I don't know. Does this give me anything? No. No fireproof armor. I mean, I could get power modded blue armor. It's not a bad idea. And I just switch between that and bulk modded depending on what I need. Wait, No, not again. Not more nanofiber armor. We're good for nanofiber armor, thank you very much. I don't need any more. Can I mod anything with this, though? Maybe. Oh, wait. What am I doing? I want those equipped. No, I cannot mod that. I can't... Ah, screw it. Just pick it up. Let's see. Still something trying to kill... Whoops. Yeah, that's a thing trying to kill me. Ow. Oh. Red armor of no use. I was hoping I wouldn't die there, but... Wait, I didn't die. So, yeah, that actually worked out. Walls explode. I keep forgetting that hell is so aptly named. Although, that was a mistake on my part. Why was I wearing my A-modded red armor when I desperately did not need to? I lost so much health from that. Whatever. It's more that I have 3 large med packs. I'm probably okay. Since I do seem to be remembering to use them. Where's the stairs? Oh, there's the stairs. I could have left as soon as I got here. I'm just so desperate to kill everything. Oh, nice. This is actually Hell's Arena setup, but I'm set up for it. Haha! Or rather, it's another maze, but now with cacodemons. So the Lost Souls will be rushing at me, and then the cacodemons are not really going to be a threat. So that works out alright. This should be... It's a nice breather level after the last two. My goodness, that was terrifying, those last two. This is nothing. What's this? The vaults. Nope. Like, at this point, I'm definitely keeping my promise about red staircases. Don't worry, I'm not going to go down there. Like, basically, it's one of those things where once I win on a difficulty level, I figure I might as well go down there, but I haven't won on Hurt Me Plenty yet. So let's just win first. And then worry about the super advanced stuff. Like exploring what vaults has, even though I imagine it has some good stuff. But, you know, dying is generally a bad idea. Oh, shoot, I only have 186 ammo.
I'm not getting a whole lot either. Switch over to shotgun. I don't have a whole lot of shells, but this is at least more efficient. Ah! Salvation. Chain gun in the middle of the nowhere. Thank you, anonymous Marine who presumably died in order to give me that chain gun. Or rather, the ammo therein. Oh, what? That's a waste. I want to drop... Nah, screw it. Drop the B-pack. Nope. Get that. Alright. High power pistol. You're not really a threat. You are threats! Get rid of them first. Gun kata, such a lifesaver. Something's through there. Namely, a Baron of Hell. Did I hear any revenants? I don't think so. What do I have to deal with here? I have some boots. I have some light amp goggles. I have... Is there a bridge in this place at all? There, probably. Normally, big rivers of acid or lava like this, there's a bridge, and that's probably right here, because it usually will explore the entirety of the lake, or all the liquids. When you get a computer map, it'll show you all the liquids, and if this is not liquid, it must be a bridge! Like, pretty much by definition, actually. Alright, let's get the light amp cock. And you're annoying. Alright, what do we have? Because I don't think there's any tracking maps. No, there aren't. I'm not quite so fortunate today. There are more Hell Barons. So that's this level's theme, is Hell Barons. Thanks for the free shot! Oh, that was a waste. Thanks for the free shot with the last bit of ammo I had in my hands. Oh well. Shit. What? Oh crap. Oh crap. Oh crap. Man, that's terrifying. Yeah, I feel like Eagle Eye's gonna be of some use. Pretty established that I quite like having it. Damn, this is bad. Might as well get that invulnerability. Alright, whatever. Let's go on the other way. I know, the important thing is that they aren't revenants, so I'll take that. Ah. But yeah, the important thing is that they're not revenants. No. Mortuary, no. I think that's just lost souls or something. Oh, no, I think mortuary is actually revenants. Well, at least the name would suggest it's revenants. We all know how I feel about revenants. So we all know that my response to that is no! Oh, crap. There we go. Yeah, you only get gun cut if you actually had your cursor on top of them when you shot them. When you nailed the kill, but whatever. The few times that it doesn't completely pay off for me is not a big deal. Especially when it's dealing with one of those mancubi. I'm fine if it's a mancubus. I have no love for mancubi. What's my speed right now? 4. Okay. Two large med packs. So this is a net loss as far as med packs go, but level 4. So only 3 more standards levels left. Until I get to... Where's the staircase? Oh, there it is. So only 3 more standard levels left until I... What the heck? This auto move is supposed to avoid acid! Whatever. What's my boots looking like? 90%, we're good. Oh good, an easy
easy fight. And now I'm an area like E2, M2. Bloody revenants. Ha! Joke's on you, I have invulnerability now. You picked the wrong place for a fight. And also invulnerable armor. Yeah, arachnotrons, those were a thing, aren't they? They are, however, as far as I'm concerned, manageable things. Yeah, that's not so good. Oh, good, the Mancubus died. Oh, come on. I wanted you to shoot stuff at me so I could dodge it and get free shots. I feel like Dodge Master has kind of gone to waste. Except right there, where it actually came in handy. All right, so... where are you? There you are. Perfect. Well, not really. I mean, I actually took quite a bit of damage there, but... imperfect, but survived. Well, actually, that wasn't too bad. I keep saying that, and yet I'm also taking loads of damage, which isn't good. Now, the question is... pretty easily answered, actually, as far as I'm concerned. Nothing to mod. All right. Forget it. I will... I'm not going to drop that. Why drop it? What would be the point? Assault shotgun. Make sure I have no bullet barrels here. All right. Was there anything else I could break open? I feel like we've gotten a pretty good tour of all the different level types, because mRL actually has quite a few different level types that can be made. You have the mazes, you have the areas like we had before where it was split down the middle, you have areas where it's a bunch of small, almost homes in a sense. You have this here, which is basically just episode 2, level 2, but as an auto-generated level, like of the original Doom, with all the crates and everything, which actually is one of my favorite levels of the original Doom. I'm not sure why, but it's a pretty cool level. Although it's also, it's got this neat maze-like quality. It's actually more like military base, to be honest. Military base is pretty much E2, M2 as a roguelike level, but for an auto-generated level, this is what that's going for. So, two more levels left. So, stairs are over there. I'm starting to think... 534, okay, there's 11 enemies on this... No, wait, 534. There's 9 enemies on the stage. One in this Narc file. How did that hit me? All right, let's think about this for a second. First off, I should have run. I get that. Second, nanofiber armor. Oh, do I have to get out of sight or something? No, that works. Do this with invulnerability. How long do I have invulnerability for? Long enough. That's all that counts. 544 enemies total. Who got rezzed? Oh, I guess something got rezzed before and I killed it already. These lava barrels really discourage me from using a shotgun. If I didn't have to, it wouldn't be such a big deal, but I really feel like using a shotgun is an invitation to death. Because the lava barrels will blow up, and then it'll hurt things, and... okay, good, that was not a large med pack. So it's Arachnotron and Mancubus are the last two enemies. Wait, what am I doing? Close doors. Ah, shoot!
Well, at least it was in the lava. Helped me some. Okay. Okay. Why did I pick that up? I don't have any plasma weapons. What am I doing? Alright. This is probably Erebus? No, lava pits. Okay, that's true. Actually, Mount Erebus is my favorite Doom level. Oh, good. I can get to full health at least. So this is level 6. There's one more left, and then Spider Mastermind. And maybe, just maybe, we'll see. But I might just win. I don't think so. I mean, it's a roguelike. You haven't won until you've won. Although I didn't actually get any tactical nukes this time. Normally I do by now. Oh well. No super final boss, but still. Spoilers, sorry. Well, sort of. Hinting at spoilers. But I should be able to get the Spider Mastermind. Like, I think if I get two of the Spider Mastermind, I'll probably be okay. But I believe it's a chain gun based weapon. I mean, I haven't played the mRL version in a while. Haven't gotten that far in a while, actually. Yeah. I have gotten that far, just not in a while. You know what? I'm just gonna do this. Power mod pack, the armor. Actually, you know what? Ooh, do I have I have agility mod. I'll keep both, but I will aim on the heck out of this armor. Armor. And I also get spare armor too. Actually, could I bulk mod? I could bulk mod something, I suppose. Bulk mod blue armor. So I have super tough blue armor. Blue armor that works like red armor except without movement speed penalty, and red armor that works like red armor but with blue armor's movement speed penalty. I should be good for armor. How do I get back here? Oh, right. That's how I did it. Okay, it's over there. How many enemies do I have? 15. How the heck do I get there? And Virus Dude's back. Oh. Nope. Shoot. Only the one med pack. This could be my death. Yeah, if they come after me, they're dead. I guess I could wait them out. What happens if I double power mod armor? Is that a thing? No. Oh well. Am I gonna gain anything from this? Screw it. I don't have any med packs. Oh, do I? I do have a med pack. I have a med pack! Yes! Okay. Alright. Ooh. Oh, there's a flinching mechanic in this one. I might be able to just pillar dance this thing to death. Ow. I'm not hitting it. Screw it. Damn it! So close! So bloody close! Should've just gone with the shotgun in the first place. Damn it. Well, at the very least, I proved to myself that the WASD control scheme with the whole auto hotkey setup does work. So close to actually winning. I was probably like two good shots away. If I just found a way to not die in that last level, not take the damage in the last level, keep those med packs and just, if I had one large med pack, I would have made that bloody fight mine. Damn it. Well, whatever. I'm just going to call it for now. Thanks for watching. Sorry I got so close and then didn't actually win. I can't believe it. It's right there. Right friggin' there. Oh, well. Thankfully, as far as I'm concerned, that run is for the item drops and such, the assault shotgun was nice, but I'd say overall it was nothing special. The assault shotgun is basically just a tactical shotgun that you can pick up. It's good. I liked it. It wasn't super special. There are other weapons I would consider to be more important, more special. But yeah, I think that was a relatively average run, and I took it all the way to the Spider Mastermind. So that's pretty good. And I didn't have any misinput issues because of the control scheme that's weird, but I really like. It feels great to me, like playing it with the shooter style controls is so cool. But anyway, hope you enjoyed that. And if you are curious about this whole thing, I made a post in the DoomRL forums, or the Chaos Forge forums, and I'll link it in the description, which I guess will be obvious by the time you get to this point. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching, and have a good night, everyone.